All right, so we have Ying Ying had run a total of 30 laps for a running class, or running club, I should say. So Ying Ying ran a total of 30 laps. Then Ying Ying ran 4 more laps before school. So she ran 4 more laps before school, 3 more laps at lunch, 3 more laps at lunch, and 2 more laps at recess. Ying Ying's doing a lot of running. 2 more laps at recess. So what I want to do is I want to figure out the total number of laps that Ying Ying ran, and I'm going to do it using a number line. So let's draw a number line here. Let's draw a number line. Let's draw a number line. And Ying Ying starts at 30 laps. She had run 30 laps, and then she keeps running more laps than that. So my number line, I could start it wherever I want, but it might be convenient to start it at 30, and I could do it at 29. And then I could go 30. Actually, let me just keep going up from there. 31, 32, 33, 34, 35. A few more left. 36, 37, 38, 39. And let's say 40. And I could go all the way to 41. That's how much space I have. So let's see. Ying Ying started at 30 laps. So she started at 30 laps for a running club. Then she ran, Ying Ying ran 4 more laps before school. So on the number line, if I go 4 more, that's going to be to the right. I'm going to be increasing by 4. So I'm going to be increasing by 1, 2, 3, 4. So those 4 laps before school take us from 30 to 34. And then she runs 3 more laps at lunch. So then from the 34, she's going to go 1, 2, 3 to 37. She's going to go to 37. So that's what those 3 more laps at lunch do for us. And then 2 more laps at recess. So she was at 37, and now we're going to go 1, 2 to 39. So how many total laps does Ying Ying run? Well, Ying Ying runs a total of 39 laps. 39 laps, and we were able to figure it out using this number line. Now let's do an exercise very similar to this that you might see on Khan Academy. So this one right over here, actually let me get rid of the stuff about Ying Ying so we don't get confused. So this says, and it's a little bit smaller, but hopefully you can see what it says, a red ant army started with 100 marching ants. So we're going to start with 100, and actually they tell us, well, let me just read the whole thing. Started with 100 marching ants, then the red army lost 3 ants down a hole. So actually lost 3 ants down a hole. 3 ants were eaten by a bird, that's unfortunate. And 1 ant just blew away. I guess ants are fairly light creatures, so that makes sense. 1 ant blew away. Which number line shows how to find how many ants the Red Army has left? Well, the army started with 100 marching ants. We underlined that over here. So we need to start with 100. So we need to start with 100. This one starts with 10. So I can immediately rule this one out. And so we could just select that one. But let's just make sure it makes sense. So we start with 100. And then we lose 3 ants down a hole, so we're going to go down. Remember, we're losing ants, so we're going to go to the left of the number line. We're going to go to lower values. We're going to go down 1, 2, 3. So these are the 3 ants we lose down a hole. So 3 down the hole. Then we have 3 that were eaten by a bird, so you're going to lose 3 more. That's those 3 right over there. Gets to 94 ants left. And then we have the 1 ant that gets blown away. So that gets us down to 93 ants left. So the red army, or the red ant army, has 93 ants left. 93 ants left. And we are done.